she's one of the world's most beloved stars, and this week Julie Andrews has been honoured with a Lifetime Achievement Award at the Venice Film Festival. Dame Julie's career spans an incredible 70 years, earning herself a well-deserved place in Hollywood history. And she's not done yet. Here's our Weekend Sunrise movie man, Jason Jabba Davis.
She's a darling of the big screen, capturing our hearts in the timeless classic The Sound of Music in 1965. Now more than 50 years on, Julie Andrews has been recognised at the prestigious Venice Film Festival, a Lifetime Achievement Award that got a standing ovation.
I consider myself so blessed to have spent a large part of my professional life in the cinema arts. I still marvel at the fact that I was the lucky girl who was asked to play those wonderful roles.
A career that began in the 1950s as a Broadway performer before trying out that new technology called TV. Then her big break on the big screen.
For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down.
It was 1963, and Walt Disney himself asked Julie to take on the lead role in Mary Poppins. It was her first film, and she was pregnant.
It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
A role that won her an Oscar for Best Actress. A year later came that other famous role in The Sound of Music.
Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun.
It was the highest grossing film of its time, and when adjusted for inflation, it's the third highest grossing film ever. In the 70s and 80s, Julie starred in several films directed by her late husband, Blake Edwards, including Victor Victoria, which earned her another Oscar nomination.
Baby, won't you play me the jazz hot, maybe?
But in 1997, her world came crashing down. Andrews underwent a simple procedure on nodules in her throat. When she woke up, her vocal cords had been damaged and her legendary four-octave singing voice was gone. She sued for malpractice, winning an undisclosed settlement, reportedly in the tens of millions of dollars. Julie turned to writing children's stories with her daughter. They've now written more than 30. And in 1999, she was made a dame by Queen Elizabeth. Dame Julie went on to endear herself to a whole new generation of movie fans, playing a queen in The Princess Diaries.
We won't waste time. Let the work begin.
And a tooth fairy alongside The Rock.
You have another assignment.
Another tooth? Are you kidding me?
Sometimes there's a double header.
7 years after her botched surgery, Andrews brought the cast and crew of The Princess Diaries 2 to tears when she sang for the first time.
Dear little girl, you are terribly blessed, but it's your heart of gold I love the best. I didn't have a voice really at that point, but it was nice just for a second.
Dame Julie also found success in animated films, voicing the Queen in the Shrek franchise, and Gru's ruthless mum in Despicable Me.
I just wanted to congratulate you on stealing the pyramid.
That was you, wasn't it?
Or was it a villain who's actually successful?
Stand by for the release of her second memoir next month, detailing Julie Andrews' Hollywood years. At 83, there's little sign of her retiring from the limelight anytime soon.
I want to thank you and all the audiences here and around the world who remain so passionate about the value of the cinema. You make all of this, all that we do, possible, and your continued support keeps the magic alive on the screen for all of us.
Oh, I want to watch that again. She's such a treasure. We watch it all the time with the kids.
Big Now House too.
I loved it as a kid growing up, and I love it just as much now with the kids. It's fabulous.
Basil and Amy just get together and watch it together.
Actually, send the kids out and we watch it.